Hello, one and all. Today I am going to discuss a new topic in inter-process communication, that is HTTP request message. Previously we discussed about characteristics of IPC and client and server communication. Today I am going to explain a new topic, that is HTTP request. Here we are using a method and we are giving the URL, some URL we have given. This is the version of HTTP and this is the we have to use a header. In method we are using a get function. So what is the meaning of method? In each client request, this is the method. In each client request specifies the name of a method to be applied to a resource at the server and the URL of that resource. You are giving the method and you have to assign the URL of that resource. Next, what is the meaning of get? Get function used to request. It is used to request the resource whose URL is given at its URL is given at its arguments. These are the two main concepts in HTTP request message. One is method, one is get. Next, we have to move on to the function name, that is header. What is the meaning of head? This request is an identical to get. But it does not return any of the different types of data. But it should be a main valuable to use an HTTP request message. After this, now we have to use 2 to 3 function. We have to post the values and put the functions and finally we have to delete the some messages. So what is the meaning of post? Post specifies the URL, universal resource locator of a resource that can be deal with the data supplied in the body of the request. This is called as a post. Next, after the post concept, next we move on to put. What is the meaning of put? The request, that data supplied into the request, and it should be sorted. It should be sorted by using an ascending order. Some sort should be ascending order. It should be a bubble sort or binary sort like that. You have to sorting technique. This is called as an put concept. Next. Finally, we have to come for delete. In delete function, the server deletes the resource and identify by the server will delete the resource and identify the given URL functions, URL messages. So this type of header field contains a challenge and HTTP version contain the version of different forms of messages. This is called as an HTTP request message. Now we'll move on to the another concept called as an HTTP. Replay message. HTTP replay message. Now similarly you have to draw the replay message versions. This is HTTP 1.1 200. I will tell what is that and okay, and this is finally resource data. This is the function. Next, here HTTP version and status code. This is status code and headers, reason headers to give an OK function, and finally this is resource data. This is called as a message body. Now we'll discuss about what is the HTTP replay message. The status code, this is the status code and reason provide. This is the reason provider, a report on the services success or otherwise it should be carrying out the request is called as an HTTP replay message. The header fields are used to pass an additional information about the server and it should access the resource. This is called as a main HTTP version format 2. Next, after this we have to use a function. And the reply message comes to use the message in a request, or reply messages contains the data associated with URL. This specified in the types of different forms of request. Next, we'll move on to the main concept, that is remote procedure call. Here we are giving the request. This is RPC, new concept, RPC, remote procedure call request, and this is reply, and this is client programming and service procedure. This is server procedures. And this is communication module. This is client process and this is server process. This is communication module. So before going to start RPC, the three issues that are important in remote procedure call. First issue, the style of program promoted by RPC programming with an interface. This is the first issue. And second issue, the call stress the associated with RPC. Next, final issue, the key issue of the transparency and how it relates to the remote procedure call. This is called as the RPC. These are the three issues we are commander in RPC. Now we move on to implementation. This is client program and client stub procedure. This is client stub procedure and this is communication module, and we'll send the request and we have to give the reply. And this is a client process and this is a server process. And this is called as a dispatches and service procedure. And finally, this is a client stub procedure and this is a server stub procedure. Now, the implementation of RPC says the client that accesses a service includes all stub procedures for each procedure in the service interfaces. The stub procedures behaves like a local procedure to the client, but instead of executing the call, it measures and it proceeds the identifier, and it should be an argument the request message. This concept is called as an RPC. When the reply message should access and arrive the marshals of request, the server process contains the dispatches together, that is called as an marshals. The dispatches servlets, one of the server stub procedure, can accommodate the RPC function to gather the request message. These are the concept we have to use in a remote procedure call. Finally, main important one concept is there, that is the server stub procedure then unmarshals the arguments in the request message and it calls the corresponding service procedure and it uses to return the values for reply the messages. This is called as an the RPC concept. So these are all for the today's class. Next, we'll discuss another two concepts. After this, we have to conclude this module, and later we'll start with module 3. Thank you. For more updates, please subscribe my channel. If you have any doubts, please put a comment in a comment box. Thank you.